Addis Ababa, 2015. What looks like any other international conference is actually a game changer in international development.
So we should have a very strengthened partnership with the business community, private sectors. There are many big companies who can mobilize trillions of dollars. These monies should be leveraged by the public funds.
Inviting the private sector to accomplish the Sustainable Development Goals, something that had largely been a public domain, was a tall order. Because private investors traditionally had limited interest in seeking out disadvantaged countries for their projects, they had to pay a premium for financing. They would cite uncertain returns and political risk. Take the example of Nepal, one of the poorest countries in Asia. A country at times pummeled by instability and natural disaster, but also a nation in need of modernizing its infrastructure. Despite vast energy resources, Nepal would not find investors for its energy sector.
Lack of electricity in Nepal has been a major constraint to economic growth. But at the same time, Nepal has a vast endowment of hydropower potential. Given the mountains and given the snow, Nepal could become a powerhouse for the region. It could not only solve its own domestic needs, but it could export to India and other countries.
What is now known as the private sector window did the trick. Money from this $2.5 billion IDA fund, designed by the World Bank in response to the 2015 call for action, was invested to lower the risk for all investors. The idea? Share risks, raise profitability, and hence attract enough investors to jumpstart the sector. Nepal finally could start building a 216-megawatt hydropower plant.
MIGA is providing political risk insurance to the investors for this project. Now, MIGA operates like any other insurer. We charge a premium rate, which covers our admin costs and our risks. What the private sector window does is it allows MIGA to charge a premium rate that makes the project economically viable for the investors. Now, if everything goes according to plan, the private sector window won't suffer any losses, and the money will be returned to be invested in other projects.
They're signaling to other investors that this is a viable project, and this attracts other investors. So now you're able to catalyze more funding towards these companies.
And it is not just a tool to catalyze large projects. It is equally helpful for small and medium-sized companies. Consider this fruit processing business. Jars are filled and labeled manually. Investment in machines would help to stay competitive, but financing in local currency is often hard to get by. With investments from the private sector window, such financing costs can be cushioned.
What IFC can do using private sector window support is guarantee those portfolio of loans for financial institutions in our priority countries.
When you invest in this kind of local production facility, you're creating a local market, a local economy, and less reliance on exports. If the project does really well, the private sector window recovers just as much positive return as any other investor in the same project. That's how we've structured it for the first few set of projects.
The vision in 2015 was to make billions into trillions. It works. The IDA private sector window has become a giant window of opportunity for the world's poorest countries.